the Mitsubishi Eclipse Cross sits between the ASX and Outlander, but it's a more resolved and engaging model than either. We've only had a few hours at the wheel, but it has all the appearance of a strong entrant into a cluttered segment. Mitsubishi has a wide range of SUVs led by the ASX and Outlander, which sell in huge numbers here on the back of commendably low pricing and a reputation for bulletproof reliability. But a brand cannot rely on such sensible metrics alone. Which is where the more alluring 2018 Mitsubishi Eclipse Cross comes in, boldly repackaging a badge once used on a compact sports coupe, to meet the modern crossover boom. Now, not everyone will be happy about that, but Mitsubishi has long signposted its intent to focus on SUVs and light commercials, so that's just the way things are going to be. Pitched between the aforementioned pair of range mates, it's designed to tackle fellow spacious but small SUVs such as the Honda HR-V, Nissan Qashqai and Subaru 15, but feasibly might also be cross-shopped against a Mazda CX-5 or Hyundai Tucson. Rather than launching with low pricing, it instead comes loaded up with modern infotainment and active safety equipment, and as such gives the cookie-cutter ASX some room at the bottom end of the market. That logic also applies to the design, which resembles the XR FEV 2 concept car, with its interesting contours and wedge shape. It's only 40 mm longer than the ASX and sits on the same 2,670 mm wheelbase, though its more commanding presence makes it seem larger. This design is enhanced, by the way, if you shell out $890 for the brilliant red premium paint that gives Mazda's a run for its money. Pricing kicks off at $30,500 for the Eclipse Cross LS, which is at least a few thousand dollars more expensive than most entry-grade rivals, and actually places it alongside a bigger but less well-equipped offering such as a Tucson Active X or CX-5 Max. On the bright side, it's not specified like a base-grade car at all. Standard features include Android Auto and Apple CarPlay, DAB Plus digital radio, two USB points, 18-inch wheels, roof rails, push-button start and keyless go, reversing camera, dusk sensing lights and rain sensing wipers. There's also standard safety equipment such as an NCAP 5-star rating, 7 airbags, 2 ice fix anchors and 3 top tether attachment points, autonomous emergency braking, AEB, and a lane departure warning chime. There's a $6,000 premium to jump into the flagship $36,500 Exceed version, which gives you extras such as leather seats with heating, LED headlights, 2-zone climate control, panoramic sunroof, and a flip-up glass head-up display like Mazda's and Volkswagen's. Extra safety tech on the Exceed includes a great 360-degree around-view camera just like Alliance partner Nissan's, adaptive cruise control, a blind spot monitor, rear cross-traffic alert for backing out of parking spaces, lane change assistance and a system that cuts the acceleration if you accidentally hit the throttle, in drive, too close to a static obstacle. The cabin is a massive step up for the brand, overtaking the Pajero Sport to be its most modern setup. Notably, there's a 7.0-inch touchscreen perched atop the dash powered by a complimentary Lexus-style touchpad. It's less immediately ergonomic than a Mazda or BMW-type rotary dial, but you adjust quickly, and it keeps smudges off the screen. There's actually a lot of Lexus in the fascia shape, and the plastic trim around the vents, though the cheap-feeling leather and black plastic on the steering wheel lose points. Not enough to take away a feeling of robustness and the look of something rather premium. The driving position gives you that desirable height over a regular hatch, sedan, and there are ample wheel and seat adjustments. The distinctive split rear tailgate doesn't impinge on rear vision all that much, reassuringly. In fact, the cabin feels open and spacious thanks to all that glass. There's also a decent glove box and console, and bottle holders in the door. What would we like to see? A Qi-style wireless smartphone charging pad is an obvious omission, and a digital speedo in the instruments as well as the HUD would be ideal. Phone mirroring won't date, though some buyers will rue the lack of a conventional sat-nav system. Warning! The back seats are fantastic for the class, up there with the Honda HR-Vs and capable of seating two 180cm plus adults with room to spare, though there are no rear vents. Commendably, the 60 hours 40 minutes split bench pieces also recline slightly, and slide on rails by up to 200mm so you can bring your baby seat closer or elongate the cargo area behind them. Fantastic idea! That said, They don't fold quite as flat as the Honda's Magic Seat setup, even if the cargo space minimum of 341 liters, growing to 448 liters with the back row slid forward, and up to 1,122 liters, and 1.4 meters long, with them flipped down, is still above average for the class. As per the class norms, there's a space-saving speed-limited spare wheel only. So that's the cabin, but how does the Eclipse Cross drive? It's not yet based on a shared Renault-Nissan platform, but Mitsubishi has done significant suspension reworking. More importantly, this car premieres a brand new engine for the company. It's a downsized 1.5-liter turbocharged petrol making 110 kilowatts of power at 5,500 revolutions per minute and a fairly muscular, for a class dominated by gutless offerings, 250 newton-meters of torque on tap between 2,000 and 3,500 revolutions per minute. Claimed fuel use is 7.3 liters/100 kilometers using 91 Romanian lei petrol, though we got high 8s on our test. It's a nice little unit, refined and responsive off the mark, with a strong mid-range that gives you better than average acceleration. It also gives you a brake trailer to rating of 1,600 kilometers. There's no alternative yet, be it diesel or, more likely, plug-in hybrid, PHEV. The engine is mated to a CVT automatic with 8-step ratios to make it feel like an auto with a torque converter, and it's generally inoffensive. You get column-mounted paddle shifters for the manual mode. The LS and entry LS are also front-wheel drive, as per the segment norms.